Right. Good day, grade 12 learners. Welcome to today's agricultural sciences lesson. My name is Fezeka Zulu. This lesson is brought to you by the Northern Cape Department of Education in collaboration with Phakama Research and Development. We are still on our revision, and today our main focus is on the paper 2. I will be teaching you on how to answer paper 2 questions, right, based on agricultural marketing and management, agricultural production factors, as well as the genetics, because these are your topics for paper 2. Now, learners, by the end of this lesson, you should be able to define the term marketing, identify and describe main functions of marketing, describe supply and demand as affected by the price or as they affect the price, identify the approaches to marketing, understanding the production factors, and understanding genetics. Now, firstly, before we even begin or start with our revision, let's just look at our paper, of which is paper 2, not paper 1. Let us look at our paper 2 structure, right? Our paper 2 structure, it should have section A and section B. Right, on section A, we should have multiple choice questions. Column A and B, give one term, correct the underlined word. So section A is out of 45 marks with shorter questions or with short questions. Now section B of paper 2. Right, section B has 105 marks, and it also has three questions, question 2, question 3, and question 4. And each question contains or consists of 35 marks. So you should be able to answer these long questions together with the shorter questions. Let us start with our section A. Now, how do we answer section A? Remember what we said last time, first rule of answering the multiple choice questions, you need to study, and then after you can analyze, you can read and analyze the statement or the description. Now, various options are provided as possible answers to the following questions. Choose the answer and write only the letter A to D next to the question numbers, 1.1.1 to 1.1.10 in the answer book. Example 1.1.11A. And we only have 10 questions in the multiple choice. And each question has or carries 2 marks. Now let us start with 1.1.1. And please always remember that when it comes to question 1, all topics are included. Now, 1.1.1, selling differs from marketing because it is, the correct answer from, it is C, of which is product oriented. Now, selling is different from marketing. Marketing is profit oriented. It involves long-term planning. It also satisfies the consumer. But when it comes to selling, the only focus is on the product that must be sold. So the correct answer is C. And at all times, you must not write the descriptions and you must write the labels. 1.1.2, example. One of the statements below applies to eco-labeling. Now, eco-labeling is part of the green marketing, where we are producing products that are environmental, we are producing products that are of nature or green products, and we are using packagings that are environmentally friendly. Now, eco-labeling. The correct answer will be B. Production promotes environmental care. We are producing or we are packaging by using packages that are environmentally friendly. Packages that will be biodegradable and recyclable. 1.3, The most important document that an entrepreneur needs in order to do source funding for a new business venture, the answer for that will be D, of which is the business plan. The business plan is the only document used to source out the funding or to apply for a loan from a financial institution. Now, 1.1.4, the type of farm worker who is employed to paint the roof of the milking parlor. Now, the key word here, it is to paint the roof of the milking parlor. And the answer for that question should be B, of which is the casual worker. Now, temporary workers are different. We have seasonal workers, we have casual workers. Seasonal workers are there to perform repetitive tasks, and then casual are there to perform non-repetitive tasks. Now, example, painting is a non-repetitive task, so it must be performed by casual workers. 1.1.5, the survival of lambs under cold conditions due to their thick fur. The correct answer should be A, of which is natural selection. Now, natural selection, a process in which animals with desirable or favorable traits are more likely to survive and reproduce. Now, due to lambs having thick fur, they were able to survive. That is natural selection. It does not involve human intervention. Now, let us move to your 1.2, of which is your column A and B. Right, choose a term from column B that matches a description in column A. Write only the letter A to G next to the question numbers 1.2.1 to 1.2.5 in the answer book. Now, each question, it carries 2 marks, and the total for 1.2, it is 10 marks. Now, let us look at these questions. These are the examples, not the actual column A and B. Right. This is your column A and B for your paper 2 or your agricultural sciences paper 2. So here there are no both A only, B only, none. Here you only select the letter that matches the description in column A. Meaning here we only have the description in column A and then the terms in column B. Now, unfavorable climatic conditions are resulting in a shortage of product. The answer will be the supply. There will be a shortage of supply. Marketing system where the state regulates prices of product. The answer will be B, controlled marketing. Now, there are different marketing systems. Free marketing, controlled marketing, and cooperative marketing. And the only marketing that is controlled by the government where there are stable prices, it is the controlled marketing system. Right, 1.2.3. Guarantee offered to the lender as security for repayment for a loan that is a collateral. And the correct answer will be the land, obviously collateral. Why? Because land, it acts as a collateral. Now let us move to 1.3. Now your 1.3, you are expected to give one word or term. And each question carries 2 marks. We have 1.3.1 to 1.3.5. Now 1.3.1, the relationship between change in price and change in demand. And the correct answer will be price elasticity of demand. Why? Because we speak of the change in demand, not supply. There was price elasticity. 1.3.2, the characteristics that are determined by a large number of genes. The correct answer will be quantitative characteristics. Not continuous variation, because continuous variation is a type of variation, but a characteristic, we can just say quantitative characteristics. So this is how you should answer, or you must answer your question 1.3. Now, 1.4. You only change the underlined weight in each of the following statements. Now, 1.4.1. Underlined is fixed. Cost change with level of production. The correct answer will be variation. The fixed are not change, or they do not change with the level of production, but variable do change with the level of production. Now, 1.4.2. Type of mutagenic agent caused by X-ray radiation is biological. Biological is underlined. Now, the correct answer will be the physical. Correct answer will be the physical. Now, let us look at our question 2. Agricultural marketing, that is out of 35 marks. Now, here you will be provided with different graphs or the descriptions, or you will have to read the paragraphs. Now, in this question, there is a graph. Now, you analyze the graph and answer the questions. Remember what I said. All your answers are in the graph. Identify the type of marketing curve that is illustrated by, that is illustrated above. The correct answer will be the demand curve. Why the demand curve? Because a relationship between quantity of spinach and price, they are inversely proportional. The graph is going down. Now, deduce the price of spinach at point W on the graph above. Now, this is our point W. And then you will just move horizontally, and then you will find that the price is 15 rand, or the price for the spinach is 15 rand. This is the correct answer. 2.1.3. Briefly explain the reaction at the market when households buy more spinach during a specific period of the year. This is a market, a situation in a market where there is a supply as well as the demand, where there is price determination. What will happen if more spinach are bought by the consumers or are demanded? Now, the demand for spinach will rise. There might be less quantities to sell. The higher the demand will increase the price. And we know when the demand is high, the price for a specific product increases. So this is what will happen in the market. Now, explain how market equilibrium could be reached. Now, market equilibrium will be reached when the supply is equal to the demand. That is your market equilibrium point. When the supply in the market is equal to the demand, that is when market equilibrium will be reached. Now, 2.2, there will always be questions regarding the marketing systems. 2.2, analyze the picture and answer the questions that follow. Identify the type of marketing shown by the picture above. Motivate your answer. And this has to be 2 marks. Now, you analyze the question, or you analyze the picture, and you need to provide the questions. Now, this picture, it shows that there are vegetables, there are also fruits, where the marketing is directly to consumers. Now, the type of marketing, it is free marketing. Why is it a free marketing? Selling, it is directly to consumers. There is no middleman. 2.2.2. State 2 possible risks of this type of marketing system. Right, firstly, it is subject to theft. Lack of storage may lead to perishability. Lack of transport may lead to the delay of the delivery of agricultural product. Lack of market, where there is no middleman, no one will market on the behalf of farmers. Competition, why? Because everyone is free to sell whatever product they want. Environmental conditions, of which will decrease the production. So these are the risks associated with free marketing. Now, state three main disadvantages of the free or of the marketing system above. Remember, we said the marketing system is a free marketing. Now, what are the disadvantages? Firstly, there will be price fluctuation. Why? The farmers are able to negotiate the price. Now, price fluctuation. Secondly, marketing costs are high. Why? Because it is only the farmer that is responsible for marketing agricultural product. And it is only the farmer responsible for production cost. Producer has less bargaining power. A producer cannot negotiate, right? Highly competitive. There is more competition. Why? Because more or a lot of producers or everyone is allowed to produce, right? Can lead to oversupply or lower prices. Not understanding the market can lead to oversupply of agricultural product. So these are the disadvantages of free marketing. Now, also in your question two, there will be questions based on the business plan or based on the entrepreneurship. A business plan is a plan of action that an entrepreneur has for the business. 2.3.1, list the four main items that should be included in a good business plan. Remember, business plan is used to secure funding, to apply for a loan or to apply for a loan from a financial institution. Right. What must be part of the business plan? Right. The name of the business on the cover page. The summary of the business plan, just to attract the investors. Human resource plan, type of labors or workers. Sales and marketing plan, how product will be sold and how is the market will be carried. Financial plan, where you will find different financial records, such as income statement, cash flow statement, balance sheet. Now, 2.3.2, briefly describe the main reason for including a business plan when applying for a loan at a financial institution. Why is it important to include a business plan when applying for a loan? It indicates all financial details. And it also shows the visibility and the viability of the business, whether the business will be able to make money or it will be running at a loss. Now, if a business is not viable, then the financial institution won't be able to fund the farmers. And if a business is viable, the banks will be able to find the producers or will be able to fund the producers for the production or marketing. So this was your question two. Now your question three has the production factors. And it is out of 35 marks. Now study the graph and answer the questions, or study the table and answer the question. Identify the economic characteristics shown by the data in the table. The answer for that will be, land is subject to the law of diminishing returns. Why? Because there is an input represented by the bags of fertilizer, And there is also a yield responsible for or represented by the bags of potatoes. And there are other economic characteristics of land that you must know, and the functions or economic functions of land that you must know for the exam. You must be able to identify these economic characteristics and be able to state and give the economic functions of land. Deduce the relationship between fertilizer input and potato yield. Now, potato yield will increase with an increase in fertilizer input until an optimum production is reached. But further increase in fertilizer input will result to an increase or to a decrease of potato yield. A decrease of potato yield. That is your law of diminishing returns. An increase in input will result to an increase in output up until a certain point is reached. But further increase in input will result to a decrease in output. 3.1.3. Name two main measures a farmer can take to make land more productive. Firstly, consolidation of uneconomic farm units. You are combining the small farm units so you can have a single large farm unit that is economical. The management becomes easier. Water management or supply water. Restore land potential, adapt to scientific methods, and the responsible use of chemicals. So these are the measures that a farmer can use to increase the land productivity. Now, in labor, laborers are faced with a lot of problems and challenges that decreases the labor productivity. And HIV is one of those factors or problems. Now, you need to read and then you need to answer the question. Describe the possible implication of HIV and AIDS for the broader agricultural industry. Now, the productivity will decrease because experience and knowledge are lost with ultimate loss of skilled labor and agricultural production. When a labor or a worker has been infected, sometimes he or she will get sick. And when he gets sick, the skills will be lost and that will decrease the productivity. Now, 3.2.3, indicate four actions you will include in a strategic plan that farm managers can use to deal with the impact of HIV or AIDS on farming operations. You can aid awareness or awareness and education. You can have access to condoms or provision of condoms, have support groups, access to antiretroviral drugs, ARVs. You can educate or have support groups and educate the farmers or the farm laborers about this viral disease. Now, when it comes to your question four, will be your genetics out of 35 marks. And these are examples that you might come across when writing question four. Now we have a diagram right here where you need to identify the type of dominance shown by the picture, motivate your answer. Now, this is the diagram where a white was crossed with red and then pink was a product of these two animals. The correct answer will be an incomplete dominant. Remember, we have three types of dominance. The complete dominance, when one parent is fully expressed, Codominance, when both parents are fully expressed. Incomplete dominance, when both parents are partially expressed and an individual will show an intermediate color. Now, it is an incomplete dominance because a heterozygous offspring shows an intermediate color, of which is pink, meaning both parents are partially expressed. Also, use letters W for white and R for red to indicate the genotype and the phenotype of flower B. Now, the genotype will be capital letter R, capital letter W. The phenotype will be pink. Also, there will be questions based on variation. The differences among individuals of the same species caused by internal or external factors. Internal factors being mutation, a recombination of gene, random fertilization, crossing over. External being diseases, climatic, topography, exercise, nutrition. And also you must remember that variation is divided into two types, discontinuous and continuous. Discontinuous and continuous. When it comes to variation, you need to read, you need to understand the phenomenon. Now, identify the process of selection repeated or referred to in the passage above. Variation is important to farmers because it is the foundation of natural breeding programs. A farmer would prefer to have animals that are ideally suited to the specific agricultural production environment. Sheep kept in the harsh semi-desert area of the Karoo have been selected by nature through drought and other harsh environmental factors. Only the one adapted to animals and their offspring manage to survive. Identify the process of selection referred to in the picture above or the passage above. And the correct answer will be natural selection. Why? Because animals with favorable condition or animals with favorable traits were able to adapt and they were able to reproduce. Now, name the two most important uses of variation in breeding. Now, variation is the foundation of selection and breeding. For farmers to select, animals have to be different. They need to be different. We should be able to differentiate animals with superior characteristics and animals with inferior characteristics. Now, number one, for the improvement of existing breeds or cultivars, it bring or it introduce new breeds or cultivars. So this is the important use of variation. So we can produce or form new offsprings and improve the existing breeds. Now, 4.2.3, describe how the heritability of characteristics will influence the success of a breeding program. The higher the heritability of characteristics, the quicker the improvement of breeding program. When there is high heritability, those are the characteristics that will be selected for breeding purposes. Why? Because it shows that those characteristics are mainly determined by the genes other than the environment. Also, there will be questions based on breeding or the breeding systems. Now, where you will have to identify the breeding systems, provide the advantages and disadvantages. Now, there is a diagram here, A, B, and C, that shows different breeding systems. 4.3.1, identify the breeding systems A, B, and C. A will have to be the upgrading. Why? Because a stud bull was used to improve right? The breed. B have to be the inbreeding, not line. Why? Because the Sussex bull was mated with the bull's daughter. C will have to be the crossbreeding. Why? Because different breeds were mated of the same species, the Afrikaner and the Shorthorn cows. Now, indicate the breeding system that promotes heterosis, or the differences. It will be A and C. So these are the two breeding systems that promote heterosis or promote hybrid vigor. Now, also there will be questions based on genetic modification, where you need to define genetic modification, advantages of genetic modification, and the techniques of genetic modification, as well as the potential risk associated with genetic modification. Now, identify the breeding process above. Genetic modification is the manipulation of genes. So animals can have, or plants could have, in superior characteristics. Now, this breeding process is known as genetic modification, or known as genetic engineering or biotechnology. State two potential risks associated with the breeding process. We have health risks, where they reduce the effectiveness of the immune system. We have economic risk, where it is being expensive. We have environmental risk, where they kill beneficial insects and reduce biodiversity. So these are the risks associated with genetic modification. Also, you must be able in the exam to identify the technique that was used to produce or to form the new plants. So this is your question four, or this was your question four. Now let's look at the summary of our today's lesson. We focused more on the paper two revision, that is section A, section B. Section A are your short questions, section B are your long questions. Section A is out of 45 marks, section B out of 105 marks, with three questions, question two, question three, and question four. Right, let us preview our next lesson. Our next lesson will be based on the revision of only marketing and management. And that is your question two, where we will cover the supply, the demand, different marketing systems, different approaches to marketing, marketing chain, also referred to as agribusiness chain, and the factors that affect agribusiness chain, where we will look at entrepreneurship, the business plan, as well as the SWOT analysis. So thank you for watching this lesson. See you next time on our marketing or agricultural marketing and management revision. Thank you so much.